And now I will give you some rules how to catch the chub. And I am glad to enter you into the art of fishing by catching a chub, for there is no fish better to enter a young angler. He is so easily caught. But then it must be in this particular way. Go to the same hole in which I caught my chub, where in most hot days you will find a dozen or 20 chevins floating near the top of the water. Get 2 or 3 grasshoppers as you go over the meadow, and get secretly behind the tree, and stand as free from motion as possible. Then put a grasshopper on your hook, and let your hook hang 1/4 yard short of the water, to which end you must rest your rod on some bough of the tree. But it is likely the chubs will sink down towards the bottom of the water at the first shadow of your rod, for a chub is the fearfulest of fishes, and will do so if but a bird flies over him and makes the least shadow on the water. But they will presently rise up to the top again, and there lie soaring till some shadow affrights them again. I say, when they lie upon the top of the water, look out the best chub, which you, setting yourself in a fit place, may very easily see, and move your rod as softly as a snail moves to that chub you intend to catch. Let your bait fall gently upon the water, 3 or 4 inches before him, and he will infallibly take the bait, and you will be as sure to catch him, for he is one of the leather-mouthed fishes, of which a hook doth scarce ever lose its hold. And therefore, give him play enough before you offer to take him out of the water. Go your way, presently, take my rod, and do as I bid you, and I will sit down and mend my tackling till you return back.
Truly, my loving master, you have offered me as fair as I could wish. I'll go and observe your directions. Look you, master, what I have done, that which joys my heart. Caught just such another chub as yours was.
Marry, and I am glad of it. I am like to have a towardly scholar of you. I now see that with advice and practice you will make an angler in a short time. Have but a love to it, and I'll warrant you.
But, master, what if I could not have found a grasshopper?
Then I may tell you that a black snail, with his belly slit up to show his white, or a piece of soft cheese will usually do as well. Nay, sometimes a worm, or any kind of fly, as the ant fly, the flesh fly, or wall fly, or the daw or beetle, which you may find under a cow turd, or a bob, which you will find in the same place, and in time will be a beetle. It is a short white worm, like to and bigger than a gentle, or a cod worm, or a case worm. Any of these will do very well to fish in such a manner. And after this manner, you may catch a trout in a hot evening, when as you walk by a brook and shall see or hear him leap at flies. Then, if you get a grasshopper, put it on your hook, with your line about 2 yards long, standing behind a bush or tree where his hole is, and make your bait stir up and down on the top of the water. You may, if you stand close, be sure of a bite, but not sure to catch him, for he is not a leather-mouthed fish. And after this manner, you may fish for him with almost any kind of live fly, but especially with a grasshopper.